So this week, we talk about Pharma Harma. I want to talk about medicines that can either cause villous atrophy or can prevent villous atrophy from healing. So those of you who don't know, villous atrophy is the hallmark symptom in those with gluten sensitivity where they have celiac disease. Celiac disease is defined as villous atrophy of the small intestine, and the problem with villous atrophy is it causes erosion of the lining of the GI tract, leading to malabsorption and severe diseases and comorbidities associated with that malabsorption. And so traditionally, a gluten-free diet would help to resolve that villous atrophy. But as many research studies show, and some show as high as 92% of people following a gluten-free diet fail to achieve a remission of damage in their GI tract. And there are a number of reasons why, but one of them has to do with the use of certain kinds of medications. So I'm going to put on the screen here for you. This is a research paper published in the International Journal of Celiac Disease. It's called Drug-Induced Sprue-like Intestinal Disease. And so, again, quoting from the abstract of this study, many medications may cause a sprue-like small intestinal mucosal inflammatory process. And going on to list them, alcohol. I know that sounds a little crazy, and many of you drink, and this could be one of the reasons if you're still struggling. Again, alcohol can be a hindrance to your recovery. So number one, alcohol. Number two, antibiotics. Number three, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen and naproxen. We also have chemotherapeutic agents. So if you've gone through chemotherapy, these are drugs that can cause damage to the GI tract. And one of the most common ones that we see beyond even cancer is the drug methotrexate, which is used to treat rheumatological autoimmune arthritis. So if you've had rheumatoid arthritis, or ankylosing spondylitis or psoriatic arthritis, the doctors oftentimes will prescribe the drug methotrexate. Again, it's one of those drugs that we know can cause villous atrophy. Also, immunosuppressive medications like azathioprine, all of these can cause mucosal changes to the GI tract. And then there's also a number of new drugs that have also been recently recognized to cause sprue-like intestinal disease. And I've talked about these before, but these include pharmaceuticals such as olmesartan. Olmesartan is a drug used to treat high blood pressure. It's also sometimes referred to as an angiotensin receptor blocker. But olmesartan and many other blood pressure medications that end in ARTAN, those are part of that ARB or angiotensin receptor blocker class. But also certain biologics that are designed to treat immunological diseases by suppressing the immune system. So if you're on any of these medications, but you've also been diagnosed with gluten sensitivity or related diseases like celiac disease, you want to make yourself aware, because if you're failing to show recovery when you follow up with your GI doctor and your damage to your intestinal tract is not going away, it's very likely or possible that these classes of medications might be playing a role. Now, I want to show you another study. If we put this up on the screen for you, you can see here a significant proportion of celiac disease patients do not heal their small bowel mucosa despite attempts of gluten avoidance. They go on to say that persistent villous atrophy has been associated with serious sequelae, including lymphoproliferative malignancy, in essence cancer, as well as osteoporotic fractures as a result of bone loss. But in this research study, again, show you on the screen, what these authors found is that villous atrophy was associated with drugs such as PPIs, which are proton pump inhibitors commonly prescribed as an antacid treatment, but also anti-inflammatory drugs, again, just like the other study I showed you, as well as different antidepressant medications classified as SSRIs or selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. So again, if you're on any of these different classes of medications, what research is showing is that persistent villous atrophy may be in the cards for you. And if that's the case, the sequelae of that can be severe malnutrition associated with lymphocytic cancers, as well as bone loss. So you want to be aware of that so you can have that conversation with your doctor. Again, if you're on any of these prescription medications, the takeaway is have a conversation with your doctor about what your risks are and what you can do to make sure that you're preventing those risks from becoming a part of your reality.